Both on TikTok and Instagram, I was tagged on this post about this woman who rejected a man's advances and who was basically hit in the face with a brick. Now, the response from women has been loud. And most of us, if we have any sense, know and understand the perils of wanting to just say no, but why we give our phone numbers to people that we have no interest in. And this is why. Look at the side of her face. Look at the side of her face. Because she had the nerve to not be interested. And this woman's video, she was so hurt. She was hurt mentally and physically because, and she's going to be traumatized going forward because she watched other adult men just be around. And there was no fear in the man that did this to her, knowing and understanding that Black women are unprotected. So like this commenter said, there should be a healthy dose of fear in what an XY will do to you. This is why so many women just acquiesce and give people their phone number and block on the back end. So when supposed good guys wonder why these women give me their phone number and then block me, understand that this is why. There's going to be women in the comment section saying this. See, this is why I tell all my friends, just give them your number, your real number. If they call in front of you, then block them when you leave. And this person says, this is such good advice. I think it's the safest way because no matter what you say, like you're married, they don't understand what no means. They say that we are the emotional ones, but our emotions is not causing us to randomly do this to people who have just said no. There shouldn't have to be a comment section where we're trying to help other women simply say, stay safe simply because we are not interested. After the Alabama brouhaha, the Montgomery brawl, I said this on my social media page, this what this woman above says. So men can only defend Black men because at that Montgomery brawl, y'all was down with it and didn't back down. I wonder if that Black woman was a security guard, would Black men have come to her defense like that? I asked this question because we have seen what happens when it's a Black woman. When it's a Black woman, it becomes, what did she say to him? What did she do? What, she deserved it because her attitude said so. Women are not, Black women are not protected. We saw what happened with Carlisha Hood. We saw what happened. She defended herself and the community, even women, were mad saying that that man didn't deserve that, despite the fact that he was pummeling her in her face. So we as women, I mean, not all of us live in a state that allows you to have pum-pums. We don't all live in those states. But we have got to recognize and have some self-preservation about ourselves because they call us emotional. But we as women know and understand that we are not protected. We're not. It's simply not going to happen. They're not going to run to our defense like they did in Montgomery. It was real cute to have all the chair memes go around. It was real cute. But in reality, we are not protected like that. It's just not going to happen. So as Cornelia said, check it right. As you all sit on social media and try to personalize these videos so you can point fingers to all BMs, understand that we aren't obligated to protect you. As more and more Black women develop a disdain for BMs just off of watching videos on social media, I don't feel the necessity to protect because it ain't all of us doing this. Correspond that with so many Black women claiming they are masculine and equivalent to men. Some things need to be thought about, don't you think? Recognize that this is their sentiment. Women are simply trying to survive. We just want to survive. And so we need to do what's best for us because they will let us know time and time again that this is, you know, because we are masculine simply because we want to be able to protect ourselves, to survive, to be independent, to live like an adult. And they take it as an affront. So we have got these social media happenings. It really reminds us all that we need to get in shape. We need to be able to run. We need to have a strong sense of who the actual boogeyman is. We have got to understand that most times they have skin like us. They are in our communities. They are looking you dead in your face. And like this person says, so we are taught that making eye contact with ladies is harassment and that you ladies are just as strong and can handle yourselves. Last time me and the fellas went to handle a man who was harming a chick, she called the cops and tried to get us arrested. So this is what they say. They say that they're not protecting you because of this. So recognize this and move on. Do what you have to do for self-preservation. That's all. That's it. That's all. It's going to get worse. Have your second number ready. Have it memorized. Have it as a Google number, whatever. Do what you have to do to stay safe.
All right, if you've been in doing deep diving, if you've deep dived into, Black YouTube, some of you probably seen this woman and shit. She's known for making a shit ton of misandrous videos that just denigrate and drag black men. She's out to just, I don't know. She's just a misandrist. She's your run-of-the-mill black misandrist or whatnot, but she, her specialty is like just sticking it to brothers and shit, okay? And just, her mousy voice coupled with that big lantern jaw. She has that fucking jaw like Mr. Incredible and shit. The Joe guy from that American Dad, she got that big ass jaw. And I've made videos, dragging her back in the past and shit. But, the algorithm always keeps me down, keeps me down across multiple channels and shit that I have. This content creator is known as Burbs and Bougie, 1980, I guess. Maybe that's the year she was spawned and shit. Yeah, this woman is a diehard misandrist, okay? She hates black men and shit. That's, what she would have you believe and shit, okay? And, I want to apologize for the Brickgate shit that's in this video, because I know a lot of us are just plain fucking tired of it. We've already pointed out in several different ways that this was a grift and presented a shit ton of receipts that was left behind by the woman because she was fucking messy and didn't clean up after herself, digitally speaking, online speaking. I don't know what the correct term is. But this Burbs and Bougie chick, she's probably one of the first chicks that parachuted in and shit on the beaches, like she going to war, to drag black men for not blindly protecting some hyena on the streets and shit. This was all a scam. But I want to tell you, a lot of you misandrists out there and shit who expect unconditional protection and shit simply because you have a vagina and shit, that the chickens have come home to roost. We do not feel the same way you do and shit. And we know that you hate us, okay? We know that a shit ton of you hate us, and a lot of you, a third of you, don't even know why. You don't realize that shit was, you were indoctrinated with that shit in your fucking home. That is generational and shit. That is a malignant part of our community that needs to die out. And, a lot of us kings are here are in the process of killing it as we speak. And we don't care how long it takes, okay? Even till the end of fucking time. But, getting back to Burbs and Bougie here, I wanted to take a look at her and shit, unfortunately, I've hit her before and shit, okay? I've hit it before. You can call her Joe Camel. She does bear resemblance to Joe Camel. And I've hit it. And, the reason I'm talking about it today is because, I wanted to prove a point about the hypocrisy of black women and shit that spew this bullshit and garbage all over the fucking, all over the net to other women, helping to keep the status quo of codependency and negativity in our community and shit, and not going anywhere and muddy in the waters and shit, keeping us apart. It's the goddamn, it's these fucking women, number one, and shit. And I don't give a fuck who says what, who says boo. And that includes Professor Black Truth, who routinely denies that there is a gender war in our community and shit. Routinely denies it, among other things. Okay, I'm not here to fuck with him. I'm not here to fuck with him and shit. You know, if he can't acknowledge what he sees in front of his face, I don't know what to tell you. Okay, all he has to do is just look. But, you know, he's got his fucking hands over his eyes because, you know, well, we have to see the bigger picture. But since I'm a smaller content creator, I can be honest, okay? No one's got their hand in my back pocket and no one's playing with my, you know, butthole or nothing, okay? All right? I don't have any allegiances and shit. And I don't have any corporate sponsors down here in the hood and shit, okay? All right? This is Burbs and Bougie. And the reason I'm showing you this is because, you know, first of all, I want you to see that she's a short, squat piece of shit. You know, she's working out. She's one of these, I like to call it heterosexual lesbians and shit. You know, these women think we want them to be more like men and shit. They be at the gym, they working out like niggas on the prison yard used to do it back in the day before they took the weights away and shit. She's working out. You know, I don't want to go out with some female that is working out like she's going to get ready for a UFC fight and shit, okay? I don't want it, okay? You know, we don't mind fit women and all that, you know, but, like, I don't want to go out with a heterosexual lesbian. I don't want to go out with somebody that's essentially a man in the brain with the vagina and shit, okay? They don't get it. They don't get it. Somebody, all this whole propaganda and shit, you know, about strong being strong, independent, and blah, 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 you know, is just part of who they are. Part of who they are. I know, you know, I've even seen my nieces who are toddlers exhibiting misandrous behavior already. And just looked at their mother, my niece and shit, she had nothing to say. She looked at the floor because she knew what I was thinking and shit. It's a part of it, you know, and, you know, they keep the wheel running and shit. You got to break the wheel. We got to break the chain and shit. They keep the wheel running with, you know, content creators like, you know, D&B here, Burbs and Bougie and shit. And she is fucking bougie and she's fake and she's a goddamn poser because here's her fucking husband. This is her family. Okay. What's her husband look like? What's her husband look like? It's a black man. Okay. She's married to a fucking black man and shit, you know, a simp, I guess we'll call him. We gotta call him a simp. If he knows anything about what she's doing, is he, you know, he's got some shades on. I don't know if he's blind or what. Maybe he's blind and maybe he's deaf and dumb. I don't know. I don't know how you could be in any kind of fucking relationship, let alone have children with a woman that does what she does on a regular basis. You know, she don't look like shit, okay, number one. She don't look like shit. It's always, you know, if you want to hear all this negativity and shit that's coming from women that nobody wants, you know, what they call the leftover women, you know, Christmas cakes in Japan. Okay. We call them hyenas over here in the colonies and shit. This is her husband. This is her family. She's the man in the house. You've seen her working out like a nigga on the prison yard and shit. You know, I personally, myself, I don't want to be with a heterosexual lesbian and shit, okay? Just letting you women out there know, I don't want to be with you. I don't want to fucking compete with you, okay? I don't need to compete with somebody I'm putting my penis inside and shit. Somebody could potentially give me children and shit. I don't need to arm wrestle them and shit and, you know, choke them out and shit just to get them to wash the dishes and shit, okay? You know, I want a bitch, you know, I want to come home and interrupt her kung fu and shit. Let's put it that way. Okay, a lot of these women, they have the weird ass mindset. You know, you couple how she's working out with her fucking mindset, it's just scary as fuck. Okay, this is where you get an Uber Karen in down here in the slave quarters and shit. And she's a goddamn hypocrite. She's a hypocrite. She talks about black men 24/7, 365 days a year. She runs her mouth, puts out negative propaganda and shit for other women to you know, digest and shit. And, you know, put out even further, spreading that shit out like a virus. And she's a fucking hypocrite because she's married to a black man. And this guy looked like he'd have been to hell and back in this relationship. He looks like a slob, you know. Even though she a fat, squat piece of shit working on her guns, trying to get her Hulk Hogan 24 inches and shit going, you know, bicep-wise. This dude looks sloppy as fuck. It tells me, just looking at him, that she doesn't even take care of this guy. She does nothing. She brings nothing to the table, and she got two insurance babies. You know, I don't know what he does for a living, but I know he's a piece of shit. He's a pussy. You know, anybody that would, you know, have a woman like this in their bed, you know, up under them and shit, protecting them. I don't know, maybe he's not foundational. Even if he is, he's still a simp and a bitch ass nigga, okay? He's a literal son husband. He's the son of his wife. Okay, he's the son of his wife. And he has a daughter, and she's learning this shit. She's learning to be an asshole like her mother. And he got a son who's probably going to end up wearing a fucking dress. Okay, that's how I feel. Now, I don't give a shit. You know, she attacks people every day without fail. And you know, this is your receipt. All right, this is your receipt. You're a hypocrite. You're a hypocrite. You hate black men and shit, but you're married to one. And you have a son. Okay? You have a son. I got nothing else. Okay, I got nothing else. SYSBM equals save yourself, black man.
The Black Patriarchy. A non-existent group of fictional black male power brokers not discredited, erroneously jailed or outright killed by the minority majority who look the other way as they work tirelessly to shame, oppress, and outright take out the altruistic black female populace of the honorable democratic United States of America. 3K's inset bitches. These evil wealthy members of the black patriarchy are the sole reason for all the ills of the black community, walking, talking, holding down jobs and doing everything up to and including giving their very lives in service to their baby mamas and baby's motherfucking kids. Their motto that strikes fear into the hearts of black women everywhere, bitches ain't shit but hoes and tricks.